On the 6th of September this year, judicial officers abandoned their week-long strike after government promised them vehicles, security and office furniture.
Can somebody meet? You can.
They had also agreed to resume the strike on the 11th of December if government had failed to deliver on its promises. But today, the judicial officers agreed to give government more time until the 12th of February 2018 as they await government to implement its promises.
So as you think of deferring this IEA, you need to be mindful that by the 15th of March, everything must have been captured in the budget. So it is important that we get this communication official.
There is no need now for resuming the IEA instruction. Let's wait, and my proposal is that we move towards next on the agenda.
So as we retreat, I call this a retreat because we are simply deferring, but as we do that, I want us to get energized so that come Feb, these big boxes in State House will have nothing else to tell us, and we shall be very bold when we face them and say, we are sitting again and the world will hear our voice.
The principal judge, Justice Yoro Kambamwine, expressed concern over the grave impacts judicial officers' strikes have had on the justice, law and order sector. He, however, urged judicial officers not to relax their demands for the better working conditions. He further complained that, despite several actions, government has been reluctant to act on the demands of the judicial officers.
We regret that disruption. We regret the condition in the prisons. I know for you, you've not been there of recent. I was there last Friday in Nakasongola with a few of you. The situation is bad. Now, if today's meeting fosters independence of the judiciary, then so be it. We don't have to be in court all the time. Yes, we need time to talk about these things.
In September this year, government promised to give judicial officers double cabin vehicles for their transport, office equipment, and a police officer for each magistrate and judge. Government also promised to increase the judicial officers' salaries to at least 8 million shillings for the lowest judicial officer. However, these promises are yet to be fulfilled. Rachel Nachwala for Urban TV.
We're going to count these hands and the previous one.